Welcome back to another free Windows 7 video. In this video, I will look at event forwarding. This process allows one or more computers to send events from their local event logs to another computer. Without event forwarding, the events from each computer will only be available locally on the computers on which they were generated. When you start managing a lot of computers, especially servers, you may want to have all the events from many different computers available in one place. This is essentially what event forwarding does. Before we get started, let's look at some terminology. The computer or computers that are configured to forward events are called the forwarding computers or source computers. The computer that is configured to receive these events is called the collector. The collector can be a Windows 7 computer, however, on a lot of networks, you will find that a Windows server has been configured for this role. Events can be transferred from the forwarding computer to the collector computer in one of two ways. In the first method, the collector will contact the source computer and ask it to transfer events. This is called collector-initiated subscription. This works well with only a few clients, but does not scale well. If you are managing a lot of computers, you will want to use the second method called source-initiated subscription. This is when the client or source computer transfers events to the collector as required. The collector does not query the client to see if any events need to be transferred. In this video, I will look at collector-initiated events. In the next video, I will look at source-initiated events. One last piece of terminology used when event forwarding is the term subscription. In order for events to be transferred, a subscription needs to be created. Think of a subscription as the settings that are used to transfer events. Subscriptions define which type of events will be transferred and where these events will be stored. In order to start using collector-initiated subscription, the forwarder and the collector need to be configured. Luckily, Microsoft provides us with only one command each for the forwarder computer and the collector computer. This will configure the service required as well as configure other required options like the Windows firewall. On the collector computer, you need to run /wec util /quick-config. This will configure the computer to start collecting forwarded events from other computers. On the source or forwarding computer, that's the computer that will send events to the collector, you need to run the command /winrm/quick-config. This will configure the computer to start sending events. However, the collector computer will still need access to the forwarding computer. You could give the collector computer administrative access to the domain to ensure that it has access. But a better way is to add the collector computer's account to the local event log readers group on the forwarding computer. Since the collector computer only needs read access, adding it to the local event log readers group on the forwarding computer will ensure that it only has the minimum rights required. I will now change to my Windows 7 computer to demonstrate how to configure a computer to forward events to a collecting computer. First of all, open a command prompt from the Start menu, making sure you right-click the shortcut and select the option Run as Administrator. From the command prompt, run the command /winrm/quick-config. This command will configure this computer to forward events to the collector computer. The first question that you will get asked is to configure the Windows Remote Management Service. The Windows Remote Management Service, besides allowing the computer to forward events to the collector, also allows other remote features to be used in remote administration. For example, it allows the ability to execute commands on this computer from a remote computer. Once I press Y, the service will be configured to delayed start. This simply means that the other services on the computer will be started first. Once these services have had time to start, this service will be started. Delayed start delays the startup of less critical services, giving more CPU to other services when the computer first boots. This should give the user a better experience when they first start up their computer. In order for another computer to connect to this computer, changes to the firewall must be made. Once I enter Y to the next question, this will make changes to the firewall. This will essentially allow the collector computer to communicate with this computer using the HTTP and HTTPS protocols. The next step is to allow access for the collector computer to the local event logs on this computer. To do this, open Edit Local Users and Groups from the Start menu. To allow access to the local computer, open Groups and then open the Properties for the group Event Log Readers. To add the collector computer account, select the option at the bottom, Add. If I enter in the computer name here, Windows will not be able to find the computer account. To fix this, press the button Object Types. Object Types will show you which objects Windows will search for. Computers, by default, is switched off, and thus computer accounts will not appear in the search results. Once Computers is ticked, I can go back to the Properties and enter in the computer name of the collector computer, in this case, Collector 1, and Windows will find the computer account. Adding the collector computer account to the local group event log readers will ensure the collector computer can read the log files on the forwarding computer and will ensure that it does not have more permissions than what is needed. Now that the forwarding computer is configured, I will now change to my Windows Server to configure the collecting computer. In this case, I will use a Windows Server 2008 R2 computer, but I could perform the same steps on a Windows 7 computer. In most cases, you will use a server to perform these steps rather than a client operating system like Windows 7. Once again, open a command prompt from the Start menu. From the command prompt, run the command wecutil with the parameter qc for quick config. This command will only ask you one question, and that is to configure the Windows Event Controller service to delayed start. Once I press Y, I am ready to start reading events from the forwarding computer. To do this, I first need to open the Event Viewer from the Start menu. Next, I need to right-click Subscriptions at the bottom of the Event Viewer and select the option Create Subscription. The event that opens will allow the properties to be entered for the new subscription. A subscription simply defines the settings that will be used when transferring the events from the forwarding computer to the collecting computer. First of all, I need to enter in a name and description for the subscription. Once this is done, select the option Destination Log to determine where the forwarded events will be stored. By default, the events will be stored in the log Forwarded Events. You can change this to store the events in any log file on the computer. I would recommend leaving the option on Forwarded Events, as changing it to another log file will mean that events from this computer and the remote computer will be mixed together. Keeping forwarded events in their own log helps to reduce any confusion about where the event came from. The next two options determine if the subscription will be collector or source initiated. The default, collector initiated, means the collector will contact the forwarding computer periodically and ask it if it has any new events. This is the easiest to set up, but does not scale as well as the next option, source computer initiated. In the next video, I will look at how to configure source initiated events. In order to set up collector initiated events, I first need to tell this computer, the collecting computer, which computer to pull for new events. To do this, press the button Select Computers. From here, I enter in the computer account name, in this case, Forwarder 1. Once the computer account name has been added, you should press the button Test to ensure the collector can communicate with the forwarding computer. Now that the forwarding computer has been added to the subscription, I will go back to the properties for the subscription. From here, I next want to determine which events will be copied to the collector computer from the forwarding computer. To do this, select the option Select Events and select Edit. You can choose as many or as few events as you like, as well as choose the type of events that you want. Remember, the more events that you choose, the more events you are going to have to go through to find what you are looking for. Choosing too many can be like trying to find a needle in a haystack, so to speak. In this case, I will choose critical and error events only. Once this is done, I need to select which event logs I want to transfer events from. In this case, I will choose all of them, but I could also just select the system log or application log if I wanted to. You also have the option to choose the events based on the source. For example, you could choose only .NET runtime events, or events relating to a particular hardware device. If you want to get even more specific, you could choose a category at the bottom, or even choose a keyword. Windows will give you a list of keywords, but you can also choose your own. For example, you could choose the disk keyword to choose events relating to hard disks. Now that all the properties have been configured, I can exit out of here and go back to the Event Viewer. You can see the subscription has been created. To access the events that have been forwarded, I need to open the Windows log Forwarded Events. In this case, no events are shown because only new events will be transferred. So that we have something to look at, I will pause the video and generate an event on the other computer. Now that an event has been generated, notice at the top of the screen the exclamation mark showing that a new event is available. To show this new event, right-click the screen and press Refresh. I can now see an event that was generated from the other computer. If I go to the general information at the bottom of the screen, you will notice that the computer that the event came from is listed. When you are collecting events from multiple computers, you can filter the logs to show a certain computer if you need to. That's it for collector-initiated subscription. In the next video, I will look at source-initiated subscription. This is when the forwarding computer contacts the collector computer when it is ready to transfer events. Thanks for watching another free video from IT Free Training.